And I have not started the recording, now started. A person sitting in an open car moving at constant velocity throws a ball vertically up into the air. The ball falls. The ball falls outside the car, in the car ahead of the person, in the car to the side of the person, exactly in the hand which throw it up. अब ये मत बोलना सर हमने तो कार बाहर ही फेंकी थी एट ऑन दैट राइट. What happened to Mungara? Mungara is not logged in with the infamous name of his. Oh, that's a beautiful comment, Meghna. Like, wow. Guys, I told, expect that you are not throwing it out. A person sitting in an open car moving at constant velocity throws a ball vertically up is a word. Not horizontally right word or left word. Right? It is vertically up. It's thrown vertically up. Right? So it will, the car, this is the ability of Maya to draw a car. Okay, I can't draw better. So my masterpieces are just like this. Ball is tossed here. This ball will retain its inertial motion toward this direction. So it will go like, meanwhile, in the same time, our dear car will also reach the same spot. Okay, so it will land exactly in the hand with which threw it was thrown up. G-I, got it. Good. Wind resistance, etc. beta, utna nahi hai. Get a better leather ball, right? What would happen if it was accelerating? Even then, in that case, dear. Okay, minute differences will be there at insignificant, like at big distances. If air resistance had to be considered, Aryan, it will be very thoroughly mentioned. Okay, if it has to be considered. Okay, and the ball is not a paper ball that it will just fly off. Yeah. But a ball, I draw the diagram, Sneha, like I represented it by the diagram. This is a car, okay? When the ball is with the car, both the car and the ball are moving with same velocity. When you throw it up, the ball retains its initial state of motion. So this ball will now do two types of motions parallel. Hence, it will land up here. Now, the velocity in this direction is same as that of car because it is received from car only. So, in the same time, they will cover equal distance in the horizontal direction. Okay. So, good. Thank you very much. Chalo, next. Here we go to the leaderboard. Ananya, beta, car is moving for. Chalo, do one thing. Utilize this, like after the class, throw a ball upward. Keep running, throw a ball upward and go. You will take it, catch back in the same end. You won't have to, don't have to stop. I repeat it. I'll repeat that back. Understand? Yes. See, dear, if the car would have been static, the ball will go up and will come down. But because the car is having some initial velocity ka direction here, this ball also have initial velocity ka direction here. Okay? Sure? the ball will go like this and come here. If your car will stop just after throwing the ball, you won't be able to reach the ball. Okay? You won't be able to reach the ball. But because your car is moving, the ball was moving, both have the same horizontal speed, they will land up, they will reach up at the same horizontal ground in the same time. Yes or no? Good. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Relax. And I suggest, if it is beta, if it is accelerated just after throwing the ball, then a different scenario, right? In that case, the velocity of car will increase, right? It will cover some more distance in the same time. Okay. If it will decelerate, it will fall before the ball, right or not? Okay, the ball will fall in front of the car. Got it, Aryan? Beta is thrown vertically up. Okay. Good. Leaderboard shows Siddharth was the fastest one to respond. Okay. There are other friends of ours. Now the difference has increased to thoda thoda sa. And let's move on to the next question. A particle is moving with a constant speed along a straight line path. A force is not required to increase its speed, decrease the momentum, change the direction, keep it moving with uniform velocity. Somewhere I got distracted because of the voice. Sorry for that. So yes, increase the speed, decrease the momentum, change the direction, keep it moving with uniform velocity. 46 people answered right, like the 45 people answered it right in the first question. 46 people now learning it out. 5, 5 and 1. Guys, please relax. Think, read and respond. By the very first law of Uncle Newton, it states that a body will continue its state of motion until unless a net external force is applied. Increasing the speed, state of motion is not kept same. It has changed. Decrease in momentum, again change in velocity. Change the direction, again change in momentum. Changing the direction will need a force to be applied. The only thing is, if it has to be let moving like the ball and the car, no force is required. Okay, sure. Here we go to the next question, and before that, the leaderboard. No numerical. Sir, there will be a, they will come, and they will surely come. Dialogue from, अरे यार ये क्या है? General knowledge test is like, I'll give you a hint. Loki. In conversation with gone. I am not in conversation with these guys. Oh, no. Loki is in conversation with no. They will come and they will surely come. Iron Man. We have our army. of aliens, we have Avengers. They will come and they will surely come. कुछ नहीं आता इन लोगों को, मैं बात ही नहीं करने वाला हूं इनसे. Now Aniket Gupta is the fastest one to respond. Pranav, Smriti and quite a good number of people. Next. Avengers 2 यार, like not Avengers 2, Avengers. If a bullet of mass 5 gram moving with the velocity, see, they will come and they will surely come. देखिए, if a bullet of mass 5 gram moving with velocity 100 meter per second penetrates the wooden block up to 6 centimeter, then the average force imposed by the bullet on the block is. The average force imposed by the bullet on the block is. Numerical, numerical, numerical. 11:25:18:02. Good. Relax and read. Relax. Bullet of mass. Mass will be required at last because its calculation of force. We'll have to calculate the acceleration. Mass multiplied by acceleration will give us the answer. Okay. Sure. Good. Now, with a velocity, there is an initial velocity. It penetrates to the wooden block up to 6 centimeter. That means before coming to a final velocity of 0, the displacement carried out is 6. Yes or no? Okay, 417 is everyone knowing this. Aryan, you are out somewhere. You are responding here. Right? Good, 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 good. Very good, very good, very good, very good, very good. Chalo. By that, by utilizing Uncle Newton's or the equations of motion, third equation, we will write V square is equals to U square plus 2A. S. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes. Good. From here, what is the value of A you will calculate, and then multiplied by mass into acceleration will give you the total force. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? Gupta. So now Gupta's your ideology is calculate time. How will you calculate time? S is equal to ut plus half at square, huh? Now you think, you tell me, how will you calculate time? Good. Uske liye, where will you get A from? No, so that's okay. Relax, huh? First thing, because you will get good and beautiful. Where did you get of A from? Yeah, exactly. For Gupta, you are saying, right? Okay, relax, understand, guys. We have three equations. We have had these kind of discussions. Okay, I should not invest time in this sometime later, but understand, all the three equations of motions are four variable at a time. In order to get some answer out of any one equation, you need three informations bare minimum. Yes or no? You know the process of solving an equation, right? हाँ गुप्ता, अरे यार मैं क्या बोल रहा हूँ तुझको, आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट वाई लाइक यू अप्लाइड समथिंग रॉन्ग और राइट. आई एम आवर एजेंडा ऑफ डिस्कशन इज कि द अप्रोच, राइट? एंड आई नो गुप्ता वोंट माइंड इट टेकिंग द नेम ओवर हियर, राइट? अनिकेत, थैंक यू वेरी मच, थैंक यू. चलो, सो नाउ वी विल गेट एसेलरेशन फ्रॉम हियर. ओके, व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ एसेलरेशन कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम हियर? What is the value of acceleration coming out from here? -100 into 100 into 100 by 12. Yes or no? Clear? Yes. Good. Everything in this system is at SI. So the force will be equal to mass 5 gram into acceleration 10 to the power 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 by 12. Okay. Sure. You have the answer. How? 10 to the power minus 3 and this will get cancelled. It will be 5000 by 12. Which is, got it? GI, got it? Good, good guys, good, good, good. Relax. अरे नहीं अनिकेत यार, फिर वही बात. अब तू, now you are exaggerating and kind of bugging one of my very dear friends, अनिकेत गुप्ता, right? ओके मेघना, हेयर वी गो. सो मास वॉज गिवेन, इनिशियल वेलोसिटी इज गिवेन, फाइनल वेलोसिटी इज जीरो, डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज गिवेन. सो वी विल अप्लाई थर्ड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन, वी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू यू स्क्वायर प्लस 2ax. गुड? नो आई लाइक यू वर काइंड ऑफ नोटिंग इट डाउन आई गेस. अच्छा, ओके 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 ओके, गॉट इट. चल, थैंक यू. Here we go to the leaderboard. So Aniket, Pranav, Smriti, Aniket, you got this bad, huh? Abhi dekh, isse tere ko nuksan hone wala hai. Theek hai? Good, Vibhav. Vibhav was the fastest one to respond. Neha, Gyanesh, Pranav are there. And here we go to the next question. A force of 100 dynes act on mass of 5 gram for 10 seconds. The velocity produced is beautiful. Prashim, dyne is a CGS unit of force. Like force is calculated in kg meter per second square. If you'll calculate force in gram centimeter per second square, then you will get gram centimeter per second square, then you will get, okay, dyne. Okay. So that, like, this is a beautiful question delivering two types of information for you guys. So force of 100 dyne force is acting on a mass m is given for 10 seconds. The velocity produced is good, 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 good. 31 people. Chop back. First beautiful scenario, dyne. Okay. Chop. But the more beauty is, you don't have to convert it because the answers are in centimeter per second. Yes or no? Now you have this concept as force is equals to change in momentum upon time. सेकेंड लॉ ऑफ अंकल न्यूटन, यस और नो? एंड यू नो व्हाइल डूइंग सो यू डोंट चेंज द मास, सो चेंज इन वेलोसिटी इज इक्वल्स टू फोर्स इनटू टाइम बाय मास. ओके, फोर्स इनटू टाइम बाय मास. इजी. द कंफ्यूजन, सी द ब्यूटी ऑफ द सीन इज बच्चे, दे क्रिएटेड अ कंफ्यूजन बट दे नलिफाइड इट बाय दैट इटसेल्फ. ओके, राइट, गुड. लीडरबोर्ड, ओके, समवॉट अ शफल इज पॉसिबल. आर्यन, अनिकेत, नैना, प्रणव, नेहा इज लीडिंग द सिनेरियोस, वेरी गुड. दे वर बीइंग अनोइंग एंड नाइस एट द सेम टाइम. हु? अच्छा, मुंगारा इज लाइक मुंगारा, टॉकिंग लाइक मुंगारा, गुड. Varsha was the fastest one to respond, and here we go to the next question. An object will continue moving uniformly until it will continue to move uniform until there is a twist, huh? Oh, Surya, like, yeah, this is a bigger problem, right? Guys, read it. The resultant force acting on it begins to decrease. The resultant force on it is zero. Main bhi nahi pad paya. I took some time but answered it right. Let's see. 27 people answered it right. 10, 6 and 12. Please guys. The object will continue moving uniformly until no force acting on acts on it. Okay. Clear? The other way, some force really exists. The resultant force acting on it begins to decrease. Still force exists. The resultant force is at right angle to its rotation. So it will be at causing a circular motion. The resultant force on it is increased continuously. Force exists. So in all the three scenarios other than B, there was a presence of force. Okay? Right? Here we go to the leaderboard. Neha, Pranav, Gyanesh, Pranav, okay, there are two Pranavs. Gyanesh is now leading the scenarios, and here we go to the next question. In doubling the mass and acceleration of the mass, the force acting on the mass with respect to the previous value decrease to half, remain unchanged, increase to 2 times and increases 4 times. Neha sir, I choose B, but it shows sorry. Is this some trick question? Thoda sa, there is a, it's the language is a bit messy. Okay. It's messed up. It's not like very straight. So like it takes a time, some time for someone to really go through that, what to be applied, what to be multiplied, what to be divided and all. It's not a tricky question. The language is not that clear. The only thing is, right? Good. 47. Both the mass and accelerations are being doubled, 2m and 2a. So the force will become 4 of the initial value. Gi, got it? Good. So we are running good with respect to time. But yes, there will be questions in the later stage where explanation will have to be comprehensive. So Ganesh, Pranav, Naina. Pranav is now leading the scenarios. Very good, very good, very good. And there we go to the next question. A force of 5 Newton acts on a body of weight 9.8 Newton. What is the acceleration produced in meter per second? Relax, think and respond, you will get it. Beta, when it is very straightforward written 9.8, then it's good to go take the G as 9.8, na? It will be easier to calculate. Aditya? You playing a different game, huh? Yes, simple and easy. Good. Nine, 26, 8, and 13. Right? Because the word here says weight. Clear? Word here state weight. You will have to go to mass. What is mass? Weight is mass into acceleration due to gravity. So from here, mass of this body will be 1. Okay? Sure. Mass into acceleration is force. So acceleration is 5. Gi. Got it? Good. Need a board. Pranav, Ganesh couldn't get it. Naina, Varsha. The fastest one to respond was Aditya. Very good, very good, very good. Here we go to the next question. You are on a frictionless horizontal plane. How can you get off if no horizontal force is exerted by pushing against the surface? Achha, Prashim has got good. Yeah, logical. Good, yaar. You guys got it. Good, 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 good. Anyone want to unmute and explain? Anyone, anyone, anyone.
So since the friction is not, I mean, it's a frictionless surface.
Yes.
So the only way you can move is by exerting a force in the opposite direction you want to move, which you can achieve by either spitting or sneezing.
Exactly. Got it? Every action will deliver an equal and opposite reaction. Your body acts this way, you will move this way. Okay? So there is no other way possible. Got it? So good. Next question. Haan, toh gravity won't stop you from sliding, na? That is what you are using. Pranav, Pranav, Naina, Aryan, and here we, Aryan was the fastest one to respond. Very good, very good, very good. Here we go to the next question. A man is standing at a spring platform, spring balance and all that, right? The reading of spring balance is 60 kg weight. Okay. If man jumps outside the platform, then reading of spring balance will first increase, then decrease to zero. Decrease, increase, remain same. I guess in order to make you guys wait, I should have kept the option number A somewhere in between, right? I don't know whether it is right or not, but just telling like that. Guys, I no 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 no. Have I revealed the answer? No, not at all. How can? There are 15 questions. So 45, 46, 47 people answering to those questions. Yes, as you will jump, you will apply a force downward. That will increase the reading of the meters weighing scale. Okay, sure. And as you will release, okay, sure, the system will remain, like, will come at neutral stage. So it will first increase and then decrease. G, I got it. Good. Read the board. So Pranav, Aryan, Pranav, Naina, Khushi, Aniket, Gyanesh, Siddharth. Sneha was the fastest one to respond. Very good, very good, very good. And here we go to the next question. A machine gun fires 20 bullets per second into a target. Each bullet weighs 150 gram and has a speed of 80 meter per second. Find the force necessary to hold the gun in position. Relax, read and respond. You will get it. Not a very difficult one. The bullet is just too heavy. It's a machine gun also, na? Read that. बेटा विच काइंड ऑफ मशीन गन यू हैव सीन? जो छोटू सा पबजी खेलने वाला मशीन गन ना, और ओ 37 पीपल गॉट इट राइट, वेरी गुड, नाइस एट कैलकुलेशंस, गुड. व्हाई, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ बुलेट इज 150 ग्राम? चलो, like you guys need some visit to some camp and all. Okay, a machine gun fires 20 bullets per second into a target. Good. Each bullet weighs 150 gram and has a speed of 800 meter per second. Clear? So, no doubt. Now understand. Forward momentum is equals to backward momentum and you call it recoil. Yes or no? Yep. Good. So whatever be the forward momentum will be the backward momentum. Okay. Sure. In order to hold the gun, whatever is the force being applied in doing so will be equal. Every action will have an equal and opposite reaction. Yes or no? Okay, now total mass being ejected per second, total mass being ejected per second is 20 into 150 into 10 to the power minus 3 gram to kg, okay, per second. So into velocity 800 meter per second. Clear? Now, easy to solve. Why? Because 1, 2, 3 will nullify this. This is 300 multiplied with 8, 2400. GI. Got it? No doubt? Good. Oh, Daksh. You miss the 8. Then 300 is nowhere. If you miss the 3, then 800 is available. No problem, no problem, no problem. Good. Okay. Leaderboard. Pranav, Aryan, Pranav, Naina, Khushi, Gyanesh, Neha, Kiranmay, Neha, Laksh. Gyanesh was the fastest one to respond. And here we go. The first machine gun had a big barrel of water surrounding the nozzle to cool it. Good. The tension in the spring is, tension is the stretch, okay? Adi. Stretch. I am feeling somewhere that the question is incomplete. Got it. I got it. The question was incomplete. No problem. Yeah, relax. The question was incomplete. Okay. Relax. Not your mistake, guys. Relax. The question was incomplete. Okay. Sure. Why? Because if this spring is getting stretched, then how much is not given? You getting my point? So might be that while some were converting the color and all, it got messed up. Okay. I'll explain. That's what. See, it can be all possible options, Aryan. With respect to the reading given, it can be all possible options. Okay. So, yes, exactly. What is tension, first of all? So understand this, bache. If simple, what I'll relate, you guys will relate easily to is, if there is a rubber band, you will pull it, it will break. Yes or no? Right? Sure. On application of the force, there exists a response like spring, especially spring. Okay. Especially and easy to understand with spring. Spring, rubber band, and all that. Okay. Suppose there is a ceiling, beta. This is a ceiling, there is a thread, and there is a mass hanging M. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
Now my simple question is, what is the force acting? What is the force acting? What is the force? Okay. What is the force? What is the force acting? Down is mg. But if mg is the downward force, shouldn't be a case that this object should go down as per Newton's first law? You'll say yes, it should go. But where is this force getting neutralized? This force is getting neutralized by generation of a restoring force, right or not, in the thread, in the string. Okay, that is the tension in the string. The very word tension, the stress. Okay, the opposition to a applied force. Clear? Right? Exactly. So now. Understand this. If by application of this, it will not stretch at all. If by application of these forces, it will not stretch at all, the answer should be 10. Okay. And then further, with respective increase in the stretch, it will become till zero. How? Oh, force is not zero. Force on the system is zero. This is a spring. It will stretch. It will stretch. No, answer is not D. That's what I'm saying, but the information is missing. The information is unclear. This question is not complete. Okay. So one by one, if there is no expansion, 10. Clear? Sure. If there is, suppose, understand, very, very simply understand. This is a loose pack of wool. Yes or no? This is a loose pack of wool. Yes or no? Then will it experience any stress because of a force being applied on it? No. It will easily open up, unwind. Yes or no? right? In that case, there won't be any tension getting produced. Okay, exactly. There has to be information given about the material. Okay, how is it expanding? How much is it expanding? Some arrow diagram over here and all that. Okay, got it? Rn not getting Rn. Chalo, come back to a normal scenario. Okay, very normal scenario. Beta, this is a ceiling. This is a wall. Okay, rigid wall. Okay, there is a hook. Clear? With the hook, there is a iron rod. Okay, you are at one end of this iron rod. You are at one end of this iron rod. Okay, so and now you are pulling it. Is the iron rod moving? Yes or no? No. Means whatever the force you are applying is getting neutralized in this direction. Yes or no? So whatever is the applied force is equal to the tension in the rod. Yes or no? Okay. Good. Now think about a thoda sa different case. There is a thick rubber band. Thick, very, very thick. Very, very thick. Yeah. Because resultant has to be zero, therefore tension is required, Rn. If tension won't be zero, who will? If tension won't be zero, who will decrease the impact of the force? Right? Got it? That's it. So now, whatever be the stretch, based on that, the amount of tension will keep on decreasing. Okay? So, suppose if it is a free wool, okay, you will just run with the force. So, whatever force you are applying is getting utilized to stretch it. No tension. Got me? Yep, good. Good, 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 good. Chalo. So, what I'll do is, I'll try to nullify the impact of this question. Beta, rigid connectors will have maximum tensions. Okay, the capability of the, like tension is in their capability to, okay, retain that is maximum. What I am doing is, I am nullifying the impact of this question. Okay. So no one will get any score out of this. Clear? Now I have like kept the switch screen over unshare mode because I was. Okay, now I have given everyone wrong. Is it okay? Neutral? Right? Good. Next question. Pranav, Aryan, Pranav, Naina, Ganesh, and here we go to the next one. So now see, we landed up in that single question, hit us so bad that we are here. But yes, it's still recoverable. We have only after this like two more questions, 3-4 minutes more. Okay. A book is lying on the table. What is the angle between the action of the block of the book on the table and reaction of the table on the book? Beautiful question. Thoda sa confusing but beautiful. Now, you know, in between when I was discussing with you, the last scenario, I got some odd 52 messages on WhatsApp. It was like continuously ting, like ting, 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 ting. So yes, a book is lying. Okay, on the table it is applying its weight down. What will be the direction of the reaction? Angle between them. Okay. Time's up. 20, 30. I told you there is a minor confusion, guys. Minor confusion. The confusion is, understand, this is a table surface. This is the book. The mg of the book acts down. The normal reaction by the table acts up. The total angle between them is 180, not zero. I told you. Thoda sa confusion is there. Got it? Got it? Good, 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 good. Here we go to the next question. Okay. So Pranav is consistently maintaining his position. Last two questions. A body whose momentum is constant must have a constant. A body whose momentum is constant must have a constant. Force, velocity, acceleration, all of these. A body whose momentum is constant must have constant. Force, velocity, acceleration, and all of these. See, the single word all of these is the only point of confusion. If all of these wouldn't be there, I know all of you might have answered the single thing. But that single word, single word, single word, single word. All of these, some message, none of these if mass is not constant. Yeah, exactly, Aniket, good. Yeah. I bola na, wo single word. Single word, single word, single word, single word. 24 people only. My dear friends, if there will be a constant force or acceleration, change in velocity will be there. Change velocity will bring change in momentum. Right? Only velocity must be constant. Told you, the single word caused the doubt. Got it? Relax. That's why it is required. Beta, please read. You know, please read. Think. Respond. Beautiful. Leaderboard. I guess there might be a good shuffle, yaar. See, RN, Sneha. RN is good at concept. I must comment on this. Like, he hardly makes a mistake while in conceptual. RN, good, is leading the scenarios. Aniket Gupta was the fastest one to respond. And here we go to the...
It goes missing. And the investigation leads you back to three generations ago.
Okay, three I'll generations. Just put...
The connection. Unmute.
The motion of a rocket is based on the principle of conservation of. Principle of conservation of rocket. Rocket is principle of conservation of. The rocket mein bacha mass is mass also changes. So the product of Aniket, कुछ भी बोल रहा है. 35 people got it right, leaderboard, and I know because there is no explanation required for this. Okay, right, linear momentum. Who's there? तो स्लो हो गया सिस्टम. आर्यन टंडन इज द विनर. आर्यन का नाम बड़ा नहीं हुआ भाई, एक बार फिर से करके देखते हैं. हो गया. तालियां. गुड आर्यन, वेरी गुड, प्लेड वेल. Guys, I did not kept the miscellaneous question because I kind of have noticed your response is good. So we'll continue this NTSC ka rounds. Okay. Learning outcome 1 to 5. Learning outcome 1 to 5. 1 being the smallest, 5 being the highest.
Excuse me, sir. Can you hear me?
Yes, Peter. Please.
Sir, what's your name? Sir Meghna. Yes, sir, can you repeat the 14th one, please?
14th one. Okay. A body whose momentum is constant must have a constant. Constant force ka supply will bring change in velocity. Constant acceleration supply will also bring change in velocity. Only keeping the velocity constant will help. Okay?
Yeah, okay, sir. Thank you.
Good.
Sir, but force and acceleration are zero, right? And zero is also constant.
Yeah, ab mazak kar raha hai. Theek hai? That's a particular solution, not a general solution. So now, what have you been through this? Particular solution and general solution. If you might have solved trigonometric equations, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Na? So that is a particular solution. Okay. So you can say must have a constant supply of zero force, a constant supply of zero acceleration, because that's a particular solution. Okay. Good. No problem, guys. Played well. Very good. Thanks a lot. Good night. Bye-bye.